Good morning, church family. I hope you are doing well. I hope you're staying safe, and I hope you're staying positive. I want to read some scriptures to you this morning. It's found in Psalm 100, verses 1 through 5. Make a joyful shout to the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who made us, and we not ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful to him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting and his truth endures to all generations. Aren't those words wonderful? And I pray that they're encouraging to you this morning. I want to pray for you this morning. And after I pray, we're going to have a word from our missionaries. They've gotten together and they got a video that they want to share with you, and I'm sure you'll be blessed by that. But let's pray for our service this morning. Father in heaven, thank you for being our God. You are our ultimate shepherd, and we are your sheep. And God, our simple prayer this morning is that you would guide us, you would direct us, you would protect us, you would lead us, because you are our God and you are good. And so we love you, Lord. We thank you and we trust you. We move forward with you today. We ask your blessing on this service. In Christ's name I pray. Amen.
Hi, church family. I have a special message from special people.
Hi, UBC, all the way from South Africa.
I hope everyone is doing well, especially in this season of Corona season, where you are able to reflect on what God is doing around the world. And thank you so much for this privilege that you have given me to interact with people here in South Africa and even minister to them with the discipleship students like you just saw in a couple seconds ago. All right, I hope everyone is doing well and have a nice day.
Hi folks, Robin here with Safe Families for Children, Maine. Want to let you all know that we continue to pray for you all and are grateful for you all as an Elliott Baptist Church family. Thank you for your generosity and your missions giving.
Good morning. We are David and Martha Markumber, serving with World Venture, greeting you from down here in Texas. I, Dave, am serving with a Filipino church in Dallas. Martha is serving in an educational ministry with missionary kids in Asia. We want to thank the missions team and all of you members of the church for your continued partnership with us.
And we are praying that God will just keep you safe from harm during this pandemic, and we really appreciate you.
Thank you, and God bless.
Hello, all you great folks at Elliott Baptist Church. I'm Ed Perrine, the CEO of His Mansion Ministries, and I wanted to take a few moments and let you know we are doing well. We are seeing God's provision in many mighty ways as we continue to serve the young men and women that He sends our way. Young men and women who have been struggling with addictions and other life-controlling issues. So I just wanted to take a moment and thank you. Thank you for allowing the Lord to be part of that provision for our needs. And as you continue to serve Him, know that He is a faithful God and He will continue to meet all of your needs and our needs as well. So many blessings to you, and again, thank you, and hopefully we'll see each other soon. Goodbye.
Greetings, Elliott Baptist Church from Tanzania. We're the Button family. I'm John.
I'm Angie.
I'm Johnny.
I'm Asa.
I'm Jackson.
I'm Xander.
Thank you for your prayers and support. We are taking similar precautions to all of you are, I'm sure, even though we're not in a state of lockdown here. And Some of those precautions, of course, have their own African style with them. We miss you all.
Bye.
Blessings.
Bye.
Thank you for your prayers and support, and please know how important you are to the ministry at Options. In the uncertainty of pandemic, the Lord is constant. Reduced hours, reduced staff, but by His grace, our doors still open 4 days a week. Virus or no virus, we continue in the love of Jesus. Our hope is to see minds change regarding abortion and to see hearts change regarding the lives of unborn children. COVID-19 has not stopped God from being God.
Hey, Elliot. This is Aaron and Stacy Jex, Kobe, Kira, and Kylie. We're your missionaries here in Papua New Guinea. We just want to say thanks for your support and thanks for everything you do for us. Really appreciate it. Kids, you want to say hi?
Hey.
Hey, Elliot.
All right, we'll see you later. Bye.
Hi, EBC. We're Bob and Judy Kuzman, and we are right down the street from the church.
We work with the Campus Ministry of CRU in the Northeast, and we are so thankful for your partnership in the gospel, and we couldn't do what we do without you. Bye.
Bye.
I was sure by now that you would have reached down and wiped our tears away, stepped in and saved the day. But once again, I say amen, and it's still raining. And as the thunder rolls, I barely hear you whisper through the rain, I'm with you. And as your mercy falls, I raise my hands and praise the God who gives and takes away. And I'll praise you in the storm, and I will lift my hands, that you are who you are, no matter where I am. And every tear I've cried, you hold in your hands. You never left my side, and though my heart is torn, I will praise you in this storm. I remember when I stumbled in the wind, you heard my crying, raise me up again. Now my strength is almost gone, how can I carry on if I can't find you? And as the thunder rolls, I barely hear you whisper through the rain, I'm with you. And as your mercy falls, I raise my hands, praise the God who gives and takes away. And I'll praise you in the storm, and I will lift my hands, that you are who you are, no matter where I am. And every tear I've cried, you hold in your hands. You never left my side, and though my heart is torn, I will praise you in the storm. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. I lift my eyes into the hills. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth.
Good morning, church family. Welcome back to my family table. It's hard to believe that it's already been 8 weeks since we first met here together and began to prepare for what lied ahead, the uncertainty of the coronavirus and how that was going to impact our lives. And if you remember, we focused on confidence in the midst of uncertainty, that even though there was a lot of unknowns and we didn't know what lied ahead, we knew that we could trust the one that was in control. And so we looked for him to give us guidance, to give us direction, to give us strength. And I pray that we're continuing to do that. So I'd like to ask you this morning, how you doing? Really, how you doing? I pray that you're doing well. I think, first of all, congrats is in order. I think this picture nailed it. So I hope you're seeing it through. You made it through April. So nice job. And hopefully we'll see this thing all the way through together. But I hope we're also thankful for this time in our lives. C.S. Lewis says this, there's no such things as interruptions to our lives. It's all part of God's plan for us. We have a tendency to view any unpleasant things as an interruption to what really is best for us. And God says, no, from the very beginning, this was part of God's plan for each and every one of our lives. And I'm so thankful for that. So much good, so much growth has happened. To watch people connect and to care about each other and to reach out to each other has been amazing. And to watch people take advantage of the time that they've had now, the time that they've never had before, to spend more time with God and more time with loved ones, really getting to know them, has been so wonderful to hear about. It's helped us as a church to focus on an area of reaching out through technology that probably, unless we were forced to do, I know I never would have went into this area. And God has given us now an opportunity and a great tool for the future to be prepared for in reaching people's lives. So a lot of good, a lot of growth has come out of this time, but it's been tough. It's been taking its toll. It's been a trying time. And though we tried to prepare the best we could and armored up, I think this picture nails it. The arrow still gets through the one vulnerable spot that we have. Times like these have a way of magnifying and exposing our true fears, our weaknesses, our shortcomings. The toll of isolation has been so difficult on so many. My heart is breaking for you that are all alone. I had a dear lady tell me this past week, as I was talking to her and asking her how she was doing, she says, Joel, you just don't understand what it means to be alone. And she was exactly right. The toll that's taken on many, you're in our prayers and our hearts go out to you. The mental strain that a lot of people are under, as stress goes up, patience and self-control has a tendency to go down, doesn't it? Suddenly we become much shorter with one another. We begin fighting over the stupidest stuff if we're not careful. This has been mentally taxing. The relationships, I'm sure that you've had to work through things that maybe you haven't had to work through in a long time. It's amazing when we're able to just go out and sort of avoid or put to the side things that we really need to be dealing with. We find ourselves together now and having to deal with stuff and not ignore them or avoid them. And I pray that you're actually growing through these times. But I'm also watching the emotional toll that this has taken. Watching two extremes happen with people. Fear of just being so scared of what today might bring or what tomorrow may bring in this new normal. It's been an extreme that many are trying to deal with, but also an extreme of people just being fed up with all of this. Human nature wants to have a cause to blame when things aren't going the way that we want them to go. And I'm watching people finger point and make accusations like never before. And we're having this emotional toll is being shown. I think also, and most importantly, I'm watching the spiritual toll. I'm missing, and I hope you are as well, the encouragement and the strength that comes from interacting with one another. Things like being online together, I hope it's helpful. But there's a ceiling to all that. We're meant to be together as people. I'll tell you, I have a new appreciation for Sunday morning. Sunday morning just sharpens me in a way like no other time of the week does. And not only when I'm speaking, when I'm being fed, but when I'm just with you and I come to church looking for the people that I can encourage, looking for the people that I just want to give a hug, actually. Yes, a hug. And all that good stuff of just being together. And I go looking to be an encouragement to others. And you all are encouragement to me, singing and serving one another and partaking in the Lord's table and getting into God's word together. I miss that terribly. So this time it has taken a toll. 8 weeks ago, I felt like I sat together and gave sort of a pregame speech as we went out and get ready to go take care of this in the best of our ability. And today I feel like I'm giving you a halftime speech. I hope I'm giving you a beginning of the fourth quarter speech, but I don't know. I don't know how much longer this is going to keep going, but I know that we've come a long way. And so I want to just remind you of a couple things. We tried to prepare the best we could. Now my encouragement is for us to persevere, to keep going, to keep honoring Christ, to keep depending on him for strength, and to keep allowing him to grow us and use us to be a light for him. So the verse that I would like to share with you today is 1 Corinthians chapter 16. We'll begin reading in verse 13, hopefully short and sweet, a couple things that you can take and apply to your life as you look to persevere through what God is allowing us to go through right now. Let's read this verses together. Be on guard, stand firm in the faith, be courageous, be strong, and do everything with love. Four things. Number one, be on guard. Be watchful. Have a heightened sense of alertness. What this word means literally is to stay awake. And the longer this quarantine goes, the harder that's becoming, isn't it? Each day sort of looks the same and it sort of feels the same. And it's tough to really get going each and every day. I was talking to someone on the phone the other day at 9:45 in the morning. They say, "You still in bed?" I said, "No, I'm not still in bed. I'm trying to make each and every day count. But I have to figure out a way to do that. I've got to force myself to fight through the fatigue, the mental and the physical fatigue, but also the spiritual apathy. Each day is so precious and I want to make each and every day count." So I've had to find a way to do that for myself, and you need to find a way for yourself as well. It's a combo of guarding, to first of all, to guard your heart and to guard your mind, to guard against an invisible enemy called the devil. That I'll tell you what, he doesn't care about social distancing. He's going after us like never before. And we got to guard against him because he's looking to infect you, to defeat you, to distract you, to destroy your life. And you got to be on guard. You got to guard your heart. You got to guard your mind. But we also, this word guard is actually an attitude of watching to anticipate something coming. We got to continue to be on a lookout. We can't just be guarding against what's bad. We got to be looking out for what is good. And God is still at work in major, major ways. And I pray that we're looking out. I pray that we're not falling asleep while we're on watch. Be on guard. Be watchful. Number two, he says to persevere, you have to stand firm in the faith. Perseverance to stand, not to fall, because your foundation is sure. Your confidence is not based on what you feel or what you see. You're confident in your faith is based on what you know, his power and his promises. I pray that each and every one of us have been in God's word, like Eve talked about last week. I've personally have claimed some Corona verses, I'm calling them. I pray that every single one of you have a go-to verse during this time that God has sent you directly to. And for me, it was Psalms chapter 18. I hope you have a chance to read that whole chapter. But here is Joel Beers' Corona verses, starting in verse 28. It says, "You light a lamp for me. The Lord my God lights up my darkness. In your strength, I can crush an army. With my God, I can scale any wall. God's way is perfect. All the Lord's promises prove true. He is a shield for all who look to him for protection. For who is God except the Lord? Who but our God is a solid rock? God arms me with strength and he makes my way perfect." That's the promises that I've been claiming. That's what I've been standing on, and it's keeping me from falling. I pray that you're claiming God's promises and relying on his power. Number three, he's calling us, if we're going to persevere, to be courageous, to be strong. Courage and strength is an essential to the Christian life. If we're going to walk by faith, you're going to have to be a courageous person. Risk is required because it's stepping out on what you do not see. We live in a world that we don't know what tomorrow is going to bring. Just walking to the grocery store has completely changed. I went to the grocery store the other week and I walked in there and I can't even put my finger on how strange it was having to stand in line and walking in there into the store, and it was just eerily quiet and everybody wearing masks. And the only conversation that was going on was somebody reprimanding someone else for being too close to them. And I'll tell you what, it took a toll on me. I walked out of there saying, is this what our world is now going to look like? Is this what it's going to feel like? Lord, please give me courage to be a Christian in these times. though everything has changed, the command from God is quite clear. Joshua, when he was about ready to face a totally different responsibility, a totally different role that his mentor, Moses, had gone to be with the Lord, and he was stuck having to lead a huge group of people into going into a territory that was completely unknown, and he was overwhelmed. And God gave him the verse in Joshua 1, verse 9. You know it well. This is my commandment. Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or discouraged, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. We can be strong. We can be courageous because God is leading us. God is guiding us. So there has to be strength and bravery. But along with bravery, this be strong and courageous is actually talking about maturity. The little definition for this is to play the man, to act like a man, to be strong, to be courageous. What a real man is about is not being all about himself, not using power for his own selfish reasons to hold over people. A real man looks to be unselfish. A real man looks to provide at risk to himself. A real man cares more about the people that God has allowed to bring into their life. See, God's calling us to grow up. See, life's not all about ourselves. God's asking us to go from boys that live in our parents' basement playing video games to men that we step out and be who God's calling us to be. It takes maturity to own responsibility. I pray, men especially, that we're owning this. I pray that we're taking care of the people that God has given us, being that those servant-type leaders that are unselfish and are being courageous to protect and provide for our families. Thank you guys for the example that you are to me with that. But be strong, be courageous. And number four, that everything you do be done in love. Can I just ask you, what does everything mean? What does all mean? Does that mean really everything that we do? There's no exceptions? That's right, everything. I know right now there's a lot of different opinions about what's going on by very good and godly people, and they have different opinions that they're very strong about. Can I just remind you this morning that everything we do is supposed to be done in love. Speak the truth in love, growing more and more in every way to be more like Christ, who is the head of our church. I like what Dr. Les Perot says. He says, truth without love is ugly, and love without truth is spineless. God's asking us to seek out truth, but to do it in love. Can I ask you, please, don't give in to becoming part of the talking points that we all hear. If we really love people around, we care about the safety and the health of those around us. If we truly love people, we care about people losing their jobs. So these two things are not in opposition of one another. It's not a side to be taken. So be so careful with these talking points. And we got to do our part to not become part of the divisiveness that is all around us, and be wise enough that we don't distract from the good news, from the gospel. It's okay to have an opinion, but when we speak, are we speaking the truth in love? Are we pointing people toward Christ? We need to love enough to do our part, and we all have a part to play. Look with me at verse 17. I'm very glad that Stephanus and Fortunatus and Achaicus have come here. They have been providing the help you weren't here to give me. They have been a wonderful encouragement to me as they have been to you. You must show your appreciation to all who serve so well. Paul gives a shout out to Stephanus and to Fortunatus and Achaicus because they stepped up. They provided for Paul where the Corinthians were not able to provide for him. They supplied what was lacking. See, it takes all of us. It takes all of us using our different gifts, fulfilling our different roles for all the needs to be able to be met. And when all of us do that, what is the result? It's encouragement. It's refreshment of our souls, as Paul says, to not just Paul, but to everyone. And Paul's response is that we got to recognize them. We got to acknowledge them. We got to say thank you to them because they are fulfilling what God has called them to do. And it's refreshing to all of us. As I look at my own life, man, I'm lacking in so many areas. I started thinking, who has been my Stephanus and my Fortunatus and my Achaicus? And during this time, I just want to give a shout out and some thanks to so many people. First of all, I wanted to thank Nate Key. the amount of work that he has put in putting all the worship videos together, along with all of you on the worship team, Pastor Eve, and so many others. You've worked so hard, and it's been such a blessing to all of us. I know it's taken hours and hours and hours, and I want to say thank you. Thank you for ministering to the Lord and refreshing and being such an encouragement to all of us. I also want to thank Michelle Austin. Her job has taken such a different role, and how much work she's doing to keep us all connected has been such a huge blessing. And I want to say thank you, Michelle. Appreciate you so much, and the quality of work you do has been a blessing to all of us. And I also want to give a big shout out to my daughter, Jordan. Jordan, for the last 8 weeks, has put all these services together, and it's taken her hours and hours every single week, because I am lacking with technology in bigger ways than you could ever realize. And Jordan has stepped in and has been able to give us services that I pray that has been a blessing to all of us. But you have been my Stephanus and Fortunatus and Achaicus, and I can't say thanks enough. Thank you, church, for being who you are. I want to challenge you. I want you to ask yourself, who has been filling in where you have been lacking? And I pray that you're going to walk away from this service this morning and go say thank you. Recognize them. Let them know how they have refreshed you and how they have helped you during this time. Be an appreciative person. Let them know. I also have a wonderful opportunity. So thankful we're able to see our missionaries this morning. And House of Hope is doing a phenomenal job of giving food to those in need all around us. And many of you have been asking of anybody that needs groceries or help. Wonderful opportunity to fill up their food pantry. You'll see a banner at the end of the service of things they need. And this Tuesday and this Thursday from 5 to 6:30, I am going to be at House of Hope on Tuesday night. Eve is going to be at House of Hope on Thursday night, 5 to 6:30, for you to just be able to drop off food or drop off a gift, a monetary gift for House of Hope, so we can continue to bless those and to meet needs where people that aren't able to have the food that they need right now. So I pray that you might prayerfully consider the possibility of helping this way. But thank you, church. God prepared us for this a long time ago, and he's going to give us the strength to persevere. Can I just encourage you, be watchful this week. Stand firm in your faith. Be strong. Be courageous. And everything you do, please, please represent Jesus Christ. Speak the truth in love. Let his love flow through you. God bless you all. I love you all very much.
Jesus paid it all.
I stand in him complete.